Thanks for joining us on the CBN News Channel. I'm Ephraim Graham.
And I'm Heather Sells. Rescue crews have resumed their search for the four missing coal miners in that West Virginia mine disaster. The crews had to wait until toxic gases were vented. 25 miners have been confirmed dead, but there is a flicker of hope that the missing four might still be alive. Wendy Griffith has the story from West Virginia.
As of right now, the miracle these coal mining families have been praying for has not happened. But even in this community's darkest hour, for Christians, there's comfort in knowing that this life is not the end.
That's why the Easter message of Jesus coming out of the tomb was most appropriate here, because those people that came out of that tomb, even the 25 that were found dead in the tomb, God has life on the other side of that. That is what faith is about.
Residents gathered at this Assemblies of God Church Wednesday night to pray for the miners and their families.
I mean, you know, this world, we're going to have tribulation, but in heaven you don't have to worry about it. You know, you'll be safe in Jesus' arm. Praise God.
Meanwhile, in nearby Cabin Creek, home to four of the miners who died in Monday's explosion at the Upper Big Branch mine, hundreds gathered for a candlelight vigil in their honor.
He was the best dad in the world.
Timmy Davis Jr. lost three family members in one day, his father and two cousins.
He loved his job. He's a good man, good father. I mean, he loved to hunt and fish, spend time with his family.
Others were just thanking God that their loved ones got out alive.
We had an 18-year-old cousin. He was there, and it was shift change, and he got out. But we did know three others that died.
West Virginians are known for being strong and resilient in times of tragedy. But Reverend Sparks says it's the church that brings hope.
The scripture says that no matter how dark it is, that God finds light in that darkness. And when you have a situation like we're still waiting for a miracle for four that are down in that darkness, that scripture becomes even more powerful.
Wendy Griffith, CBN News, Montcoal, West Virginia.
President Obama is in Prague, Czech Republic this morning. He and Russian President Dmitry Medvedev signed a landmark treaty to cut both countries' nuclear arsenals by nearly a third. The pact between the two former Cold War foes shrinks those arsenals by a third of its current stockpiles. President Obama calls the treaty an important milestone for nuclear security and U.S.-Russian relations.
I believed then, as I do now, that the pursuit of that goal will move us further beyond the Cold War, strengthen the global non-proliferation regime, and make the United States and the world safer and more secure.
The treaty must be ratified by the Senate and Russia's legislature.
An important American ally in the war on terror is experiencing upheaval today. Protests sparked by huge hikes in fuel prices and electricity left 68 people dead and hundreds injured in the Central Asian nation of Kyrgyzstan. The violence forced the country's president to flee the capital, and an opposition group says it has formed an interim government. Kyrgyzstan hosts a U.S. air base in the city of Manas. That base is a key transit point for supplies to U.S. military operations in nearby Afghanistan. The opposition has called for the closure of the base.
Afghanistan's government is trying to cool down a dispute with the U.S. The White House refused to call President Hamid Karzai an ally after he blamed foreign powers for the country's election fraud. Then came word that Karzai threatened to join the Taliban if the U.S. and its allies don't stop pressuring him. Now Karzai's spokesman is denying those reports.
The government of Afghanistan, in which President Karzai is a democratically elected president, has fighting against terror and fighting against those who put the lives of Afghan people in danger as priority number one. And in that context, that comment, whoever has come up with that context, does not make sense.
Karzai is supposed to visit President Obama at the White House next month. The administration says that invitation may be revoked.
We have an update on the U.S. soldier who has been held prisoner by the Taliban since June. The Taliban have released a video they say is Bo Bergdahl, the only known American serviceman in captivity. The site Intelligence Group, which monitors terrorist websites, made this video available. Now, there's no way to verify when the footage was taken or if Bergdahl is still alive. The 7-minute video shows the captive pleading for his release.
I'm a prisoner. I want to go home. You know, the men, the Afghanistan men who are in our prisons, they want to go home too. It's let me go. Get me to come home.
Bergdahl vanished last June in Afghanistan, 5 months after his arrival there.
Staying in the Middle East now, where the Obama administration is having problems with another long-standing ally. Some are calling the recent tension between the U.S. and Israel the worst diplomatic crisis in more than 3 decades. Chris Mitchell takes a look at how Israelis view this relationship.
The crisis began nearly 1 month ago during the visit of U.S. Vice President Joseph Biden, when a local planning board approved the construction of 1,600 more apartments in a Jerusalem neighborhood, a location Israel felt it had a legitimate right to build in. But Secretary of State Hillary Clinton called the announcement insulting. Later in the month, the White House refused to allow the press to cover a visit by Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu. Many here and in the U.S. saw that as an unprecedented public snub to an Israeli leader. These actions and others by the Obama administration have many Israelis worried. Renan Giessen was an advisor to the former Israeli Prime Minister Ariel Sharon.
So on the one hand, I think people in Israel are very confident about the shared value, the shared heritage, the shared relations, and even the shared and common enemies that we face, particularly after 9/11. But they're quite worried about the president. They're quite worried about the publicized, I would say, expression and his background. And they say they don't know because they were used to different kinds of presidents.
A recent poll showed an overwhelming majority of Israelis feel the Obama administration's attack on Israel for building in Jerusalem was out of proportion. 75% of Israelis felt the Obama administration overreacted. The recent crisis seems to reinforce the view many Israelis share about the Obama administration. For example, another recent poll showed just 9% of Israelis feel the Obama administration is pro-Israel. Some suspect the Obama administration is more interested in regime change in Israel than in Iran. Giessen believes the crisis over building in Jerusalem obscures the real danger in the Middle East, a nuclear Iran.
There's a critical question, a strategic critical question, and that is what's going to be on the agenda? Jerusalem, which cannot be resolved right now, or Iran? We got to put Iran on the agenda and take Jerusalem off the agenda.
But whether that agenda will change remains to be seen. Chris Mitchell, CBN News, Jerusalem.
And Iran has issued a warning saying if Israel launches an attack, Iran will strike back by launching missiles at Tel Aviv.
A Qatari diplomat who sparked a bomb scare aboard a United Airlines flight will not face criminal charges. A flight attendant alerted air marshals of smoke coming from a restroom on the Denver-bound flight. Officers subdued the man when he emerged. Senior law enforcement officials say no explosives were found, and the diplomat was sneaking a smoke in the bathroom.
An American described as a devout Christian was sentenced to 8 years of hard labor by North Korea. Ajalon Mali Gomes is from Boston and teaches English in South Korea. He was photographed in early January at a human rights protest in the demilitarized zone between the North and the South. He was detained by North Korea just 2 weeks later. Experts believe he could be released as a bargaining chip with the U.S. over North Korea's nuclear program.
Concerns are being raised that the U.S. Census violates the Federal Defense of Marriage Act. That's because a government TV ad is directing same-sex partners to check the married box, even if they do not live in a state that allows gay marriage.
Same-sex couples who are married or who consider themselves to be spouses can identify one person as a husband or wife.
Now, CBN News contacted the U.S. Census Bureau about the ad. They told us one of the most fundamental principles of the U.S. Census is that it is based on self-identification and self-response. We believe we get the most accurate data when people freely provide their answers to the questions.
A church in Oakland, California is trying to battle sex trafficking and child exploitation in their city. Members of the Victory Outreach Church of Oakland held a public awareness event outside their city hall. Each week, church members have been trying to reach women and girls working as prostitutes. They say they've met dozens of teens and young women forced into prostitution. The pastor's wife said, quote, "We're just letting them know there's a destiny for their life. basically, they're all victims. Sylvia Vigils is the pastor's wife. A man was convicted in Oakland of human trafficking just last week.
The Global Congress on Holy Spirit Empowerment in the 21st Century kicks off today in Tulsa, Oklahoma. Christian leaders from around the world are gathering to discuss the move of the Holy Spirit in modern times. We spoke with Billy Wilson of the International Center for Spiritual Renewal, who's helping to organize the event.
We hope that a new generation, a generation that really wants to change the world, will connect with the power of the Holy Spirit in a brand new way. Every move of God, every time in Christianity, we're only one generation away from extinction. That is true in the Spirit-filled movement. Even though there are over 640 million people on planet Earth presently who claim to be Spirit-filled, we know that the new generations are critical to the advancement of this movement. And most importantly, they're critical to world evangelization in the 21st century. We want a new generation to be filled with the power of the Holy Spirit to evangelize the world for Jesus Christ.
You can see much more of our interview with Billy Wilson later on the CBN News Channel.
Coming up, helping an athlete begin the journey back from public scandal.
Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart.
These are the most powerful songs of our time.
Now is the time to
And now, for the first time, the biggest praise and worship songs are together.
How great is our God.
Presenting Songs for Worship 50. 50 songs in one specially priced collection.
Holy is the Lord, God Almighty. The earth is filled.
You'll hear 50 beautiful songs of hope.
I'm coming back to you.
50 powerful songs of faith. Get Songs for Worship 50 on three CDs for only
$24.99.
But wait, order in the next 10 minutes with your credit card and we'll take $15 off. That's right. You get 50 praise and worship songs for just
$9.99.
Then preview other great praise and worship collections. Satisfaction guaranteed.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
So call now and get Songs for Worship 50. 50 beautiful songs on three CDs for just $9.99.
Call 1-800-435-3414 to order Songs for Worship 50 on three CDs for $9.99 plus shipping and handling when you use your credit card. Call now or order online at timelife.com/songsforworship50.
Well, the Masters Golf Tournament starts today, and of course, all eyes will be on the return of Tiger Woods. It's his first tournament since his sex scandal captured headlines last December.
Now, the road to recovery isn't easy for athletes whose public image is tainted by moral failure. Quarterback Michael Vick is one of those athletes. Michael shared his story in a rare public conversation with Coach Tony Dungy, the man who helped him walk that road from jail back to the NFL. Coach Tony Dungy is one of the most respected leaders in NFL history. In 13 seasons, his teams won 139 regular season games, 9 playoffs, and Super Bowl 41. But his influence may be even greater off the field.
I retired to something.
In his retirement, Coach Dungy works with people in need, including serving as a personal mentor to the Philadelphia Eagles' number 7, Michael Vick. The relationship began while Vick was serving 18 months in prison for dogfighting.
I was one of the few people that was allowed to go in there and visit. And, of course, coaches and general managers and everybody calling and saying, what did you see? What did you think? Is he really remorseful? And you can never tell that, but I did know that he wanted to come out and make a difference.
For the first time, the coach and quarterback share some of those candid jailhouse conversations at this Athletes in Action Super Bowl breakfast, sponsored by Campus Crusade for Christ.
the first question I asked you was not about what had happened, but where you wanted to go from here.
Our conversation started off with, you know, just a question that I didn't expect. But, you know, my response was, you know, I wanted to come back out and redeem myself and do whatever I could to, you know, help as many kids and be an ambassador in the community and do humanitarian work.
Dungy's mentoring is grounded in faith. He is the grandson of a minister, and he accepted Christ at an early age.
I asked Mike one other question that really, the way he answered it, got to me. I said, hey, when you were in Atlanta, you're making $130 million, you got Nike endorsements, you've got Gatorade endorsements, you've got number 7 jerseys being sold all over. Where was the Lord in all that?
I think I started off by saying, you know, I was so self-centered and so concerned about myself and what I had going on that, you know, I forgot about the Lord.
Finding his faith helped Vic make the return to football, but the game was not the most important reunion on his mind and heart.
One of the questions I asked Michael, if you remember, is, you know, what was the toughest thing about being in there? And you remember what you told me then?
The toughest thing about being in prison, to my recollection of what I told you, was being away from my kids and not being able to get back the 18 months that I lost in their lives. And they was devastated about what happened. I was devastated, and to this day I still have to explain to them why I left for such a long period of time.
Fatherhood, faith, and football are subjects Dungy writes about. But as a mentor to Michael Vick, there is something else he wants the public to consider. Forgiveness.
The thing we have to understand as a country is, hey, that may have been me. You know, I've made mistakes in my life that maybe haven't been as public, but we all make mistakes. And forgiveness is a part of what God wants us to do.
Vic says Dungy has given him 4 rules to follow. Don't be bitter. Don't seek revenge. Hold on to his faith and be a man of his word.
Up next, how to take the fear out of filing your taxes.
Israel, the land where God came to mankind. Imagine to be in the place where our Lord lived, to stand where he performed his miracles, to see where he taught the multitudes. The pages of the Bible come alive in the land filled with God's promises. Don't miss this experience of a lifetime. Visit Israel. You'll never be the same.
Call today.
Each week, thousands of concerned parents and grandparents start Globe Young American plans for their children and grandchildren. The Young American Plan is a simple, affordable way to secure valuable life insurance protection. Starting a Young American Plan today guarantees the future insurability of your loved ones. Once issued, the Young American Plan can never be canceled. For just $1, you can start a Young American Plan and feel safe knowing you've provided your child or grandchild with a lifetime of protection. The regular premium you establish now is guaranteed to never increase. And the Young American Plan builds cash value that can be used in the future. Since 1964, millions of concerned parents and grandparents have started Globe Young American Plans for their children and grandchildren. Call Globe today.
Call right now for complete information about the Globe Young American Plan. Call Globe today at 1-800-457-4154.
Israel, the land where God came to mankind. Imagine to be in the place where our Lord lived, to stand where he performed his miracles, to see where he taught the multitudes. The pages of the Bible come alive in the land filled with God's promises. Don't miss this experience of a lifetime. Visit Israel. You'll never be the same.
Call today.
Former Federal Reserve Chairman Paul Volcker says the U.S. should think about raising taxes to pay for the huge government deficits in the years ahead. Reuters reports that Volcker suggested a VAT, or value-added tax. Now, a VAT is essentially a national sales tax, but it does not replace other sales taxes. It's a new tax added on top of those you already pay. Conservatives have warned that President Obama's health care plan would eventually lead to new taxes, including a VAT.
Well, tax day is just 1 week away, and more than 25 million taxpayers are faced with the terrifying prospects of IRS audits, assessments, or even worse. But tax expert Dan Pilla says there is a way to file from home and do it without fear.
Two greatest fears among Americans during tax time are the IRS can do anything it wants legally, and tax mistakes equal jail time. But tax litigation consultant Dan Pilla says these fears are false. He says people are too quick to submit to federal tax notices instead of fighting them. As a result, millions of responsible Americans end up paying untold billions each year, money they may not even owe. In his book, The IRS Problem Solver, Pilla offers practical advice for those who file on their own, as well as steps to combat the IRS the next time the feds come knocking at the door. Pilla takes on subjects from audits to tax debt caused by current or former spouses. And he says you can solve your tax problems easily, legally, and inexpensively. Pilla's book provides real-life scenarios along with steps and even form letters to combat the claim. It's all just part of his mission to help ordinary Americans in their battles with the tax agency.
Recently, Mark Martin spoke with Dan Pilla for more tips on how to help lessen the anxiety during tax time.
And tax expert Dan Pilla joins us now. Welcome, Dan.
It's good to be here, Mark. Thanks.
Appreciate your time this morning. Now, tax time equals anxiety for many Americans. Give us a few basic things that we can do to lessen that anxiety when April 15th rolls around.
Well, I think the most important thing that people need to understand is when they sign that tax return, Mark, they're responsible for what's in the return. So you've got the burden to prove that that tax return is correct if the IRS questions it. And that's true even if a tax pro prepared the return for you. So make sure you understand what's in the tax return. Make sure you have records to prove what's in the tax return if the IRS challenges it. Another thing is if you don't have the money to pay the taxes that you owe by April 15th, which is the biggest source of anxiety that people
sure.
have, is I want to give you a secret tip, and that secret tip is IRS Form 1127. It's called an application for an extension of time to pay the taxes. And if you file that form on or before April 15th, you can get up to 6 additional months to pay the taxes without penalties.
Well, what are some of the biggest mistakes that we make when we file our taxes?
Well, I think the single biggest mistake that people make is not understanding what's in the return. You know, it's like I just said, you've got the responsibility to know what's in that tax return. People don't know what's in their return. If they had a preparer prepare it, a tax pro prepare it, they just sign the return where the guy points his finger, you know, and they don't realize what's in their tax return. So you have to understand what's in the return.
Say you get a notice from the IRS or you find out you're going to be audited.
Sure.
What do you do?
Well, let's talk about the computerized notices and then we'll talk about the audits. Computerized notices are wrong about half the time. So people need to understand that you've got a right to respond within 60 days. If you don't believe you owe the money, you respond in writing. You tell the IRS, hey, I disagree with your calculation. I demand an abatement, which is nothing more than a cancellation of the tax debt. When you respond in writing within 60 days, the IRS has the responsibility to cancel the debt, and then they have to send you an itemized statement of why they think you owe this money, which gives you an opportunity to make an intelligent decision after you read this statement, what to do or, you know, what to do or not to do if you owe the money or don't owe the money. When we're talking about tax audits, of course, that's a little bit different situation. When the IRS issues an audit notice, a lot of people make the mistake of believing that they've made a mistake and now they've been caught, and that's not true at all. The IRS selects returns somewhat at random. It's not a completely, you know, name out of the hat situation, but it is a situation where the IRS does not know whether you made a mistake or not, and they're just simply questioning the tax return. So now you need to understand what the IRS is questioning, prepare your documents to support your tax return, and you'll get out of the audit with your money in your pocket.
Okay, so don't roll over and play dead,
exactly,
in other words,
exactly.
Actually question it. And again, your book here is called The IRS Problem Solver, and your goal is not to protect deliberate criminals,
no,
people who
absolutely.
Are trying to get out of paying. I mean, if someone owes legitimately, they need to pay.
Well, no question about it. There's millions of people across the country that are honest citizens that are in trouble with the Internal Revenue Service through no fault of their own. There's any number of reasons why people get behind on their taxes, and what this book does, The IRS Problem Solver, is it takes you through the process of using the taxpayers' rights that are on the books in the tax code to solve the problems that you have. We're not talking about cheating. We're not talking about avoiding or evading responsibilities. We're talking about using the laws that exist right now and the rights that you have now to settle these problems so the IRS doesn't run you over in the process.
You can find out more about Dan's book, The IRS Problem Solver, at our website, cbnnews.com. We'll be right back.
Introducing Easy Combs, the easy new way to create dazzling new dos. Simply slide in one end, stretch it around your hair, and slide in on the other side for an updo that's brand new, or fluff it out for a fountain effect. Look again. The bungee band stretch and release for a relaxed custom fit every time. Liven up a ponytail or create this amazing butterfly twist. It's great for short hair and ideal for the office. It's perfect for any formal occasion. Ouch, claw clips hurt, but Easy Combs are soft and comfortable, so easy to use, kids love them too. Now get Easy Combs in caramel bronze for only $10. Call now and get one in dazzling silver. As a special bonus, get our Bermuda Black plus a styling DVD. Just pay separate shipping and handling. With the step-by-step DVD, Easy Combs are a cinch. You get caramel, silver, and black, plus the style guide and DVD, a $60 value, all for only $10.
Call 1-800-520-1486. You'll get the bonus Easy Combs as advertised when you call 1-800-520-1486.
Love to shop for shoes, but there's no place to store them? You're always running out of room to store more. Introducing Shoes Under, the easy solution to organize and protect your shoes. The clear zipper cover locks out dust and moisture. Now you just slide and store. It's that easy. With two handles, you can easily store your shoes here, under there, almost everywhere, and turn an empty space into a super storage place. Other shoe organizers can cost a fortune, but through this exclusive television offer, you can get the 12-compartment Shoes Under for only $19.99. Call now and we'll cut that price in half. That's right, for only $10. And as a bonus, we'll double the offer and give you a second Shoes Under that's enough space for 48 shoes. Just pay separate shipping and handling. Call now and get two Shoes Under for only $10.
Call 1-800-943-1652. You'll get a second one free, so call 1-800-943-1652. That's 1-800-943-1652. Call now.
Well, finally today, they say everything is bigger in Texas, but when it comes to burgers, the biggest may actually be in California.
Okay, take a look at this. One Orange County, California restaurant dishes up a hefty 4-pound burger that's bigger than a human head. This is the OMG burger. A chef first puts it on the grill, then finishes it in the oven. Now, the big burger comes with a little mayo, 12 slices of cheese, onions, tomatoes, pickles, and lettuce. And it is the creation of the restaurant's owner, Joe Manzella.
It's a lot of everything. You know, it's like a salad on a bun with a 4-pound patty. It's got a whole head of iceberg lettuce, two whole tomatoes, a whole onion, a few kosher dill pickles.
It's then served on a 14-inch round brioche bun surrounded by 4 pounds of French fries. There's, of course, no word on the calorie count. I'm thinking that could be a family meal, though.
Yeah,
you know, you all go in together.
Yeah, that's it. A big family
right,
meal.
Right, right.
That is going to do it for this hour of the CBN News Channel. Remember, you can find information on all the stories you've seen here at CBNNews.com.
And, of course, you can also stay up to date with CBN News through Facebook, Twitter. We hope you'll join us next time. Have a great day.
Fresh, wholesome juice. There's nothing like it. But until now, you had to stress and strain and make a huge mess to get just a little bit of juice. But not anymore, thanks to the Jack LaLanne Power Juicer. You can drop in whole vegetables, whole fruits, apples, oranges, celery, cucumbers with no chopping, no slicing, no struggling. And thanks to the Power Juicer's revolutionary patented extraction technology, you can get up to 30% more juice than those other juicers. Doctors recommend we get 5 to 9 servings of fruits and vegetables every day. With the Power Juicer, you'll be drinking your recommended daily allowance in just seconds. And the pulp from the extra large pulp catcher can be used to make pasta sauces, healthy desserts, and much more. The Power Juicer is dishwasher safe, so cleanup's a breeze, and the powerful motor is guaranteed for life. Order the Jack LaLanne Power Juicer now for just 2 easy payments of $49.90. And as part of this special TV offer, we'll also send you this amazing recipe guide filled with over 60 of Jack's favorite recipes. Try the Jack LaLanne Power Juicer in your home risk-free for 30 days. If you're not completely satisfied, send it back for a full refund of the purchase price, no questions asked. Call now.
Ready in the set? Going to Dr. Robertson in 3, 2.
On December 3rd, 2009, Pat Robertson entered the studio to update his landmark work, The Secret Kingdom, to help people live abundant lives amid today's challenges.
I want to talk to you today about The Secret Kingdom. What is The Secret Kingdom?
The Secret Kingdom, Volume 1, available now.